Hello friends, this is me Chaya Sharma. So friends, today we are discussing about the new chapter, that is quadratic equations. Friends, you are already familiar with quadratic equation that I have told you in my previous chapter, that was polynomials. So the new thing that is ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. That is not new thing. The new thing is that this one is the standard form of quadratic equation. This is known as the standard form, where a is not equals to 0. Means a is not equals to 0. See friends, in this chapter we will get the question of this type. Means the question will ask to you that the given equation or given question is quadratic equation or not. See, I am giving this question here. By solving this question, we have to find the equation we will get, that is quadratic equation or not. So I am solving this question here. As you know how to solve this bracket, so now I am solving x square plus 2 to the power 2 plus 2 into 2x equals to 2x plus 3. Now x square plus 4 plus 4x equals to 2x equals to plus 3. Now x square plus 4x minus 2x plus 4 minus 3. As you are seeing, I am taking the RHS part to the LHS part. So now I am solving this. X square plus 2x by subtracting this plus 1 by subtracting this. So we are getting our equation. This equation is the quadratic equation because this equation is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. So it is known as the quadratic equation. Now I have already told you about the splitting method. By splitting method we found the zeros of equation. But in this chapter we call the zeros as roots. Zeros and roots are all same, but we will call the zeros as roots. Okay, so now I am giving one example here. 3x square plus 6x plus 3 is equals to 0. You all know how to split the middle term. If you don't know this, so please see my previous video of chapter polynomial. So now I will split the middle term here. So I am seeing firstly the first and last term. Now we will multiply this term, so we will get 9. And our prime factors are 3 into 3. And by adding these prime factors, we will get our middle term. So I am now putting here 3x plus 3x in the place of 6x. Now we are making parts. And for first part, I am taking here 3x is common. And in bracket x plus 1. And for second part, I am taking plus 3 as common and in bracket x plus 1. It is equals to 0. Now, you are seeing the brackets are same. So, in another step, we are taking x plus 1 in first bracket. And second bracket, we will take 3x plus c, 3, as you are seeing here. So, now it is equals to 0. Now, it is easy to find the roots or zeros for this question. So now I am finding this. X plus 1 equals to 0. So x equals to minus 1. And for 3x plus 3, we have 3x plus 3 equals to 0. So 3x equals to minus 3. And x equals to minus 3 upon 3 is x equals to minus 1. As you are seeing that our roots or zeros are same. So it does not matter that they are same or not. If you want to verify that these are the roots for this equation 3x square plus 6x plus 3. So for verification, we will put the value of x in the equation. See, I am putting here 3x square plus 6x plus 3 equals to 0. Now I am putting minus 1 in the place of x. So we will get our verification easily. Now 3 into 1 plus minus 6 plus 3 equals to 0. So 3 minus 6 plus 3. 3 minus 3 equals to 0 and 0 is equals to 0. Now we get that our verification and our solution is all correct. So I'm closing my topic here. If you are understanding this topic easily, so please like this video, share this video to your friends by which they can also understand this easily, subscribe this channel, and if you are having any type of doubts or problems, so please comment me your doubts. Thank you.